When I go live with my new Business Central solution, of course, I would like to import my open customer ledger entry to be able to apply them later on when they are paying. Therefore, I will go into my general journal, and the strategy for doing this opening would be that I will post my customer on one hand and the customer account on the other hand, meaning that the chart of account goes into zero. So first of all, let's just look at the chart of account shortly to see that we have no entries in here as for now. So if I dive down into my entries, nothing is posted in here. Let's go back again. And now I want to enter all the lines with my customers, and I want to enter my document number manually, whereas in my batch name, I would suggest that you create a batch name specifically for this. I've made one called customer opening. I'll get back to that. But just let me show you here in the manual batch name that I'm in now. If there's a number series here, I will remove the number series, and I'm not forced to use a specific number series. So in this case, we have no number series. I can enter my document type as being an invoice. If it's a normal customer ledger entry, I can enter my document number, meaning my posted sales invoice number or whatever it is that I have here. I can select my account type being a customer and the account number as the customer. And I could use the description field maybe for my order number. In this way, I have both my original sales order number from the old system and my document number being my posted document. You just have to be aware here that this description is the field used on the entries, and also the field, the information used if you make a bank statement, so the customer will actually see this description. Then you will enter the currency code typically, and of course the amount for the open customer entry. And if you use dimension, in this case I use project code, you can enter dimension code or whatever dimension you have to enter them as well here. And you have to be aware of if you're doing a combined customer ledger entry, this should be of course per dimension. And last of all, I'd like to enter my balance account number. And as I said in the beginning, I would like my balance account number to be my customer account, so therefore I have to search for my customer posting group where I can see my customer account. Here we are. And I can see I've only one receivables account here for all my customer posting groups. So therefore I'll just enter that receivable account here. And now I'm done. I can fill in all the line in this way. Of course, if I have a line with a credit memo or a customer ledger entry, which is a credit memo, I'll do exactly the same exercise, but of course, as a credit memo. Now I've cheated a little here. So if I look into my customer opening journal, I've entered this already, of course, filling out the document type, customers, the description, the currencies, the amounts, and the balance account and project codes. So now I'm able to post this journal. Here we are. And if I look into my chart of account now, in here, and I dive down into my entries and remove the filter, I can see all the GL entries that it made here, all on the same GL account number, with the balance account being my customer number out here. And if I go into, I can see this is only one account here, 85005, and if I drill down to that or search for that, I will see that the balance is zero, which it was meant to be. Whereas if I go into my customer ledger entry, in here, I can see that it created all my open customer ledger entries just like I have expected, with all the correct amounts. So in this way, I get my open customer ledger entries in here, and I still have a chart of account which is zero, so it's possible for me later on to post a complete opening balance.